Hello boys and girls, Mike here, Wango ShortPlay, playing Afterburner for the NES. Afterburner? I thought this was like a Sega exclusive. It's a Sega game, isn't it? It is? Sega? Tension? Uh-oh. Is that a good thing? Gonna find out. So, I don't know if you guys know. It depends on how much you watch my videos, I guess. That's a bit static, wasn't it? Okay. Shoot missile! Oh, it's a... I don't like that. That scrolling's a bit epilepsy-inducing, if I'm honest. It's only 5 frames of animation! Can I do the roll? Can't do the roll! Do the roll! No. Oh, there we go. I don't know how I did it. You pull one way, and you pull the other. Roll. Oh.
Oh, no, battery's low.
That went quick. Never mind. We'll deal with that in a minute. It's not the best version, I'll be honest. I didn't like this on the likes of the Spectrum either. It just didn't really carry over very well for me. I did like it on the Mega Drive, and I suspect the Master System's good too. It's a Sega game though. It doesn't really seem to have been done with the reverence it deserves. Afterburner was one of those games that feels a bit lucky in places, and a bit unlucky in others. So you have to take your good luck with your bad in this game, I guess. You know, when you take a hit, you take an unexpected hit as often as you dodge unexpectedly in this game. I just never felt there was much skill about it. It was all about getting your money off you, and that's me talking as a Sega kid who loved Sega games. The games I love were the likes of Shinobi, Streets of Rage, E-Squad, platformers, beat 'em ups, brawlers, and character-based stuff. I guess I didn't really go for Outrun in a big way. Third games on the Amiga, like Lotus 2, Jaguar XJ220, which were later games, granted, but, you know, Outrun, I did get it, I really enjoyed it. It's a really well-designed game, and it's fun. It wasn't as good as the hype, in my opinion. It is good, though. I'm gonna let it go. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, if those of you who know that, we're doing these NES games, I've never played NES games, really. Maybe once or twice as a kid. I'm long forgotten. But I heard, I read a comment somewhere. I've read it a few times that the reason that the NES is so potent is because it's got the best games library between it and the Master System specifically. But between it and other consoles as well, like the Mega Drive. That was a nice show. I'm quite liking the homing missiles thing. So I thought I'd put that to the test. Having never really played on one, I'm being a bit more objective now rather than being a Sega fanboy. I'm just looking for good games on a good games console. I don't really care if it's Sega, Nintendo or what. I bought a SNES recently-ish, well a while ago now, but I haven't bought any games for it, and the same goes with the NES. I acquired the NES and I've got about 3 games for it. I want to find out more. I want to test this statement that it had a library of amazing games. And that's why I'm doing that on this channel now. My Mega Drive list is really about nostalgia and discovering the Mega Drive games I'd never played. And my Amiga list was about nostalgia and basically playing everything again. And yeah, discovering Amiga games I never played. But let's face it, a lot of the ones that I never really played were because they weren't very good. There's a lot of rubbish on the Amiga. A lot of Amigas and stuff too. That's what I'm looking for on the Amiga playlist. Although I haven't played the Amiga for a while. I might get back to that at some point. But the NES playlist is all about new discoveries for me. I'm basically finding stuff that I might want to buy when I've got money, which I haven't now. So window shopping, if you like. This is me window shopping. That was a nice set of shots, wasn't it? I'm getting... The mechanics of this version are different to the arcade in that it takes less moving around, but I'm getting it and I'm quite liking it. It's not as good as the original Afterburner, but it's designed in such a way that look is less of an issue, I guess, if you know to use the controls. So what I'm doing on my little mobile phone here is a list of good NES games, and as I come across them, ones that I would buy on a cartridge if they were like a fiver, I put them on the list. and then I check eBay to see if they're a fiver. And some of them find that, and some of them find a lot more. And it's a nice little, ooh, unlucky. Or just a bit, playing a bit rubbish. It's a nice little way of fulfilling the needs of a retro, God, battery's going, retro gamer, playing emulation, but keeping the intentions pure, kind of, with a view to buying some originals. That said, you buy the originals these days and the developers won't see a penny, so, you know, knock yourself out on the emulation front as long as, as far as I'm concerned. It's about paying the developers what they deserve, I think. They don't get that. I know that as a games artist. but yeah, that's what this is about. This NES playlist, and you guys can get to see along with me what's good and what's not, what's hot and what's not. Games like this, pretty mediocre. It's all good. It is what it is. It's a decent-ish port of Afterburner. nothing to write home about. Back in the day, it was probably a good alternative to the arcade machine if you for the home console market. If you had a NES, it wasn't bad. It wasn't great. It's Tengen. Were they renowned for good games? I'm not sure that they weren't. It's not bad. It's alright. It's Afterburner. As you would expect it to be on a NES. A little bit limited. But it's clearly recognisable. It's clearly decent. Now, I'm going to go and charge my battery. And if I get a bit of time, I'll do a few more videos. And if I don't, I won't. Afterburner, NES. Thanks for watching.